guys, welcome to Snowbreak Containment Zone, and we are here to review the kit of Chenxing Ethereal Cloud. So we have here Siris as well, but let's move first with the kit of Chenxing. So Chenxing start off with her standard skill. So it's damage, electrical damage, then this is more electrical damage, which attaches to maximum of 8 targets. So two damages to be dealt. So 50% of Chenxing's attack for the spiritual slip hit. And when once it detonates, there's another 70% damage. Okay, this scales on Chenxing's attack. So take note of that. Okay, next up is going to be her support skill. This one, however, is going to be up to 5 targets in front of her. When it hits a weak spot of the target, Scarlet Thunder attached, a Scarlet Current passes through all targets once and deals electric damage. Scarlet Thunder has a 25% of Chenxing's attack. And this one, Pure Lightning, is 20% of Chenxing's attack. So Scarlet Current damage is 100% of Chenxing's attack. So she has three types of damage for the support skill. So cooldown is 8 seconds. So triggering the Scarlet effect, weakness recovers 1 ultimate energy. When Scarlet Thunder Counterblade first hits a target, inflicts it with the paralyzed effect for 2 seconds. So once you upgrade neural skills, then it adds a paralyzed effect for 2 seconds. So again, both of them, both her standard and her support skill, are going to be scaled by her attack stat. Next up is her ultimate. So Chenxing combines all spiritual slips and Scarlet Thunder formed a celestial key. So this one is bombarding a certain area. So a celestial key damage is 350 of Chenxing's attack plus 117. Number of fierce thunders in the dominant zone is 15. Damage of each fierce thunder is 120 of Chenxing's attack. So celestial key hits, resets the attached duration to all spiritual switch slips in the area, and when in dominant zone, increase ballistic damage taken by enemy. So this will increase how she hits with her gun. Okay, and the last one is her alignment. So when Chenxing Ethereal Cloud is equipped with an electrical weapon, shot hit has a 50% chance to increase the damage by 32, which is nice. An additional 8% for each 100 alignment index. Again, that is good. Her kit, if I may say, is going to be built more on the ballistic side. So most of these will be supporting her with her output is going to be more on ballistic damage, guys. So she's not going to be reliant more on her skills. She's going to be dealing more damage with her gun. Okay, so for her weapon, this is Rolling Clouds. Increase electrical damage by 18 and crit damage amplifier by 12. So if you want the amplifier to kick in, you need to have a decent crit rate for her. When dealing electrical damage, gain 1 stack of Crimson Cloud, max 50 stacks. After obtaining the max number of stacks, stack clear and Crimson Sky Shield state is activated for 5 seconds. In this state, attack is increased by 21%, which is a nice addition because again, she will be dependent. Not independent, but she will be maximizing her damage with ballistic damage. Okay, so logistics wise, she is equipped with this one, Mingyi Squad. This is the one that was released, so it's gonna be designed for her. So office increased ballistic damage by 24 when dealing electrical damage. This is actually built for electrical damage anyway. Increased attack of the equipping operative by 1% for 3 seconds. Max is 45 stacks, which is a maximum of 45% increase. This is damage increase, electrical damage increase. Repeat triggers will reset the duration. So this one is going to be part of her kit. Ideally, again, as you can see here, it's going to be alignment index, attack, and electrical damage as the buffed stats for her logistics. And her manifestation, guys, is going to benefit ballistics damage. This one is for skill. This one is going to be ballistics damage, crit damage amplifier. This one is going to be ballistics benefit. And this one is going to be skill. So her manifestation is a mix. 3 benefits ballistic damage, 2 benefit her skill, which is nice because she's gonna be, she, for me, she is going to be more of the ballistic side, but her skills wouldn't hurt her, you know, her skills would not hurt if they complement her. So that is what I meant to say. So again, she is going to be more of the ballistic damage side. So guys, if you want to get her, and if you want, if you're into more of a, if you're more of a gun person, then she's the girl for you. If not, if you think that she has better standard or support skill than Wild Hunt, I don't think so. She is going to be more, you know, she's going to be better than Wild Hunt for her gun, not for her skills. That is what I'm saying. So again, choose wisely. It really depends if you need her at this point. We do have a couple of We do have a couple of options already. But if you like her kit, be my guest, guys. I think she's going to be perfect for some stages, for some teams. So this one for Siris, the goldfish, we're gonna be getting her free. I'm just gonna be going over a quick quick description of her skills, not going through all of it. This one, her standard skill is going to be a damage reduction. Her support skill is a shield, a one-way shield going out of your gun, going towards you, of course not. And the shield doesn't have a time limit. It just disappears when the damage that it receives is exceeded its HP. And also for her for her ultimate, it's going to be damage reduction as well, and increase in movement speed, reduce damage taken. So that is her skill. So again, if you're gonna use her specifically for for support, then she is going to be perfect for you. Let's do a demo for Chenxing Ethereal Cloud. And let's see how she does in battle. I come bearing blessings. Okay, so her standard skill is a bit tricky because you need to hold it, then release it. Not enough to change anything. So you need to hold the standard skill. Not much of a demo, right? So let's do that again. Let's do that again. That was so easy, it's not really worth recording it. She's at level 80, so what do you expect? She's gonna crush the enemy. Let's do another demo. Let's do another demo on her ultimate. So got carried away there. So let's do another demo, guys. So her standard skill is hold, then release. I come bearing blessings to all things. So let me just try. Okay, so the damage, if you haven't used her standard skill, as I was actually seeing, is that when you shoot, it's only gonna be the middle. But if you use her standard skill there, once it's attached, once you shoot with your gun, even the, what do you call this, the small thingies are going to be hit. So that is her ultimate. Her standard skill, actually, once you lock onto it with as you pin, I think, feathers, they call it, then your gun deals additional damage to it, as you can see there. So again, let's do that. If before the standard skill, if you haven't done that, you wouldn't be able to hit the 4 orbs that was following the main one. So again, that is her mechanic. her skills basically is going to support her ballistics damage. So again, if you like her build, guys, I would suggest you get her. After doing this review again, I'm actually going to be pulling for her. So watch out for that video. For now, my assessment is, if you fancy her gun and if you like her mechanic in which her standard skill complements her gun, which increases the damage of her gun with different targets, then go for her. I think she's going to be good. But again, guys, it really depends if you need her at this point. I won't say that she's a must pull. I don't think she's a must pull at this point. But if you want her playstyle, her design on how she deals damage, then get her. If you think that you're already okay with your team, then definitely save up for the next OP. She's not going to be OP, because we already have a lot of AoE mob killers in this game. She's just going to add to that. So at this point, it's up to you if you want to have another version of an AoE damage dealer or not. So thank you guys for staying this far. Again, her ballistics damage is going to be one of her strong suits, if not her strongest suit. So take care, stay safe. This is the Warden, and I'm out of here.